go alone. You are in command of the Spear of Adun now.
Until you return.
I have come seeking the Xel'Naga.
The shrines call this place the Temple of Unification. The Xel'Naga are somewhere within.
So far, all I've encountered are hybrid. I've been fighting them for days. Progress has been difficult.
The prophecies foretell of two ascended races working together to seek out the halls of revelation within the temple. Only with both present will the shrines reveal the means to awaken the slumbering Xel'Naga.
I've never cared much for prophecy.
And yet, despite our history, here we stand, together. A bold plan. Let us make for the shrine. It seems that... future is... Halt! Do you sense that? A great power awakens within this construct.
Purity of form. Purity of essence. Prove your strength.
Speak.
Strength in unity.
So the constructs hold the keys. Good to know.
Let us proceed. With honor, I lead. These devices emit solar energy. We should gather them.
Our knowledge is your heritage.
Look out! Hybrid! I need answers. Another construct. We'll have to destroy it to open the doorway. No time like the present.
The key is still missing. There is a powerful energy across this chasm. Kerrigan, remain here. I must investigate this. Kerrigan, the construct is coming for you!
Boldly. No time like the present. I am the Swarm.
Fate is with us. The shrine still functions. There. It gathers power. It should be active shortly.
Friends of yours?
Not quite. It appears Amon's forces have found a way into the temple. We must slay them all.
I think I'm starting to like you, Artanis.
With honor, I lead.
Let's go. It won't be long until our enemy pushes further into the temple.
It seems you were correct.
Well then, shall we?
The future is ours. Destiny awaits.
Research continues.
Constructs. There can be no doubt. future is ours. Together, we are strong.
What fools you are to attack me!
Our path is clear. Together, we... This passage has caved in as well. Wait. Hybrid.
The search continues.
There can be no...
Ulnar shall serve as your tool.
Is clear. The Tal'Darim are breaching into the Hall of Revelation.
Ready your blades, Templar. Look like they're covered with pictograms. How do you know what they say?
Communing with the shrine is more than reading carvings. Each atom of the stone has been placed with meaning, purpose. It was here, from Ulnar, that the Xel'Naga began to seed the universe with life. They created us, just as they gave life to a numberless assembly of races in other universes. Every time, they observe and identify the potential of their offspring, never interfering. The infinite cycle will always be the same. Two races are destined to emerge. One, pure of essence, an indomitable spirit capable of great change, and one, pure of form, a being capable of vast psionic potential, able to house the essence of a Xel'Naga. Purity of essence and form, the Zerg and the Protoss. If the Xel'Naga do not interfere, then it was Amon who uplifted my people. All we thought was the Xel'Naga was a lie.
Come on, Artanis. We're not far from having some answers.
I believe this must be the final hall.
Wait. The doors are open. The constructs destroyed.
The shrine is under attack! This can only be a work of Amon. We delay no longer. Our salvation will not be stolen. With honor, I lead.
Let's get to that shrine.
The dark god has foreseen your death, Kerrigan.
Together, we are strong.
Push them onto the infinite abyss.
With honor, I lead. There can be no doubt. Vyash. The future is ours.
Our future is as one in the void.
A bold plan. With honor. Our destiny awaits us. For Zeratul. For Ire.
Only darkness awaits.
Artanis, these gods of yours have a lot to answer for.
Ahead of us, within the Chamber of Ascension, the Xel'Naga have slumbered as civilizations grew, fell, and formed again. They will awaken when the two destined races arrive. Then, the elders among them will give their lives to bestow their essence. And pure of form and pure of essence will be reborn as Xel'Naga, shepherds of the infinite cycle.
Something's not right here.
Xel'Naga. No.
They're dead, Artanis.
Thank you.
not so easily broken, Amon. The firstborn shall fear you no longer!
Matriarch, there is a massive output of void energy spiking from the temple below.
Target the epicenter.
Listen to me, Matriarch. Amon's tribe is sprung. Your leader is in grave danger.
You think us fools?
Yes, but that is irrelevant. What is relevant is that Amon has opened a gateway to the void. Dark energies pour from within, and they will burn through your precious leader and any who oppose Amon. I can guide you to Artanas before this fate befalls him. If we are bold, we can stop the Dark God's assault.
Am I to believe that the moment you're released, your blade will not be in my back?
You waste time. Lower your blades. I am Alarak, first descendant of the Tal'Darim. Amon has betrayed my people. Retribution will be claimed for this, and if your hierarch survives, he will aid in it. Make your decision.
You will take us to Artanas.
Most wise.
I have brought additional defensive ability online, Matriarch. Please visit the Solar Core to configure it.
Matriarch, the Keystone has begun absorbing void energies at an unprecedented rate.
Then this Tal'Darim speaks the truth.
Void energies flood from the temple. With each passing moment, the threat grows. I do not trust him, but all data points to the scenario he describes. A gateway to the void has been opened.
Is there any way to pinpoint Artanas?
No. The energies are making us virtually blind.
We must put our faith in this Tal'Darim. It pains me to do so.
Zelnaga's failure.
This Tal'Darim has brought warriors with him. Perhaps there is a benefit to his presence after all.